Guy in the black shirt, what'd you notice about your tribe?
It seemed like we all knew what we were gonna get. We got all the water, we got all the beans, we got everything we needed.
I plan on day one to take the leadership role. Now, is that gonna be a shared role? It depends. The characteristics and the qualities that I have as an individual has been forged like an iron thrown into the fire and coming out unshakable, unbreakable, invincible like a sword.
I consider myself a Renaissance man adventurer. I'm a university head soccer coach, and the polar opposite of that is that I'm the conductor and artistic director of a symphony in Northern California.
We're gonna go there, stop, look at the compass, okay. Look at the map again.
I've always used to being a leader by inspiring, pulling out the best in everybody, because as we all know, a team's only as good as its weakest player.
But I wanna tell you something, I wanna change this game. It's survival of the weakest, it's survival of the people that can't survive in the wild, and you and I can change this game by making the strong survive.
If we look back at our ancestors, whether it be American Indian, whether it be the Norse Vikings, whether it be the samurai warrior, they prayed for an opponent that was worthy enough to defeat them and died with honor and glory in the battle.
So I know I'm making myself honorable to you by letting that out of the bag first, but that's what I'm talking about, you and me change the game. Iron sharpens iron, baby.
Candace, she has a personality like mine. She looks to find faults in other people. I do it because I'm a coach, and I do it because that's my job. And I think that maybe she just does it because that's her nature.
Coach, do you think anybody would tell you this early in the game if you didn't mesh?
At this point, you got to go with your intuition. And if you're clashing with somebody, you've got to sense that on your own. Because I guess at this stage, nobody's going to tell you that.
Not only did she align herself with the wrong person, Candace, she has completely insulted all of our intelligences when we came back tonight, and she said, you know, I've just been hanging around with Candace the last couple of days because I just wanted to see what she was up to because I didn't trust her. For her to say that to us is insulting, which is why she never would have been in my alliance from the very beginning, and she's made her bed and she's gonna have to lie in it.
I let out a scream at the end of the challenge, a primal yell that was about a quarter of what I felt inside, because I was so pissed off. I was totally embarrassed. I mean, there's no other word for it. We were humiliated.
See, have you seen Sierra?
Yeah,
she screams. She's like, I can't hear, every time.
You're like my assistant coach.
Thanks, and he's always cracking a joke. One of a kind. I mean, that's probably what attracts me to him so much. You know, not in a sexual way.
I don't care about comfort. No shelter. Let me bury myself in the sand, get eaten by tarantulas and bitten by snakes. I don't care about comfort anymore. I don't care about anything else except for winning this game.
Dude, the look.
What?
The look on Aaron's face. I'm so pissed off, man. When she saw Jerry, it registered that she was still staying. She went, I'm not kidding you. I practiced her look. She went like this.
I think my relationship with Tyson started out like head coach, assistant coach.
Coach, you agree with that? Brendan's the guy that should be leading this tribe?
Being the devil's advocate, let's say Brendan is the leader, he has to take the reins.
I'm not suggesting that I'm the leader, but on the truck, I was making eye contact with everybody, and the reason why it worked so smoothly is because I basically told everybody with my eyes to get what they needed to get.
So it sounds like you should be leading.
Well, absolutely. I'd love to be the leader. That's what I'm used to doing.
Aaron, you had about 5 different reactions. Just share one with me.
I think it's a role that Coach is used to. It's a role that he would love to be in, but it's something that Brendan does better.
Coach?
Again, I'm not criticizing Brendan, but we've lost 3 challenges in a row. And for her to be so quick to say that, I think comes more to a personality clash between us two. It's not about ego, because I would rather toe the line and be a good assistant coach than try to be a head coach and stroke my ego. What I was doing was I was justifying why I should be the leader and why I registered surprise when Aaron said, it's Brendan.
If Brendan got voted off and I was a leader, I think this tribe would be better. But I don't want to vote Brendan off, because that's my MO. I want iron that sharpens iron.
There's only one experienced person out here as far as being out in the outdoors. That would be me.
These people here are new kids on the block. What they've been doing is not succeeding, not thriving, but existing. If you look at me, you look at Brendan, who looks stronger? I do. We need to thrive in the wild and not just exist. If we merge, he has control of the game, and I'm a bystander. And I certainly don't want that to happen.
I told you I saw a snake in there last night, man.
I thought you said you were dreaming about it.
Maybe it wasn't a dream.
Oh, my gosh.
I swear, man, I looked up. I thought I saw a snake going through the rafters today. I'm not kidding, but then I thought it was my reoccurring dream of being in the Amazon. Tonight, we're going to play Peter Tchaikovsky's Marcia Slav. And it goes like this.
Okay.
And then I cue the strings. Ready? And that means I want a little crescendo and then a decrescendo. A lot of people don't want to talk about who's going to be eliminated. Tyson and I, we're thinking about it every day.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you this. I told you this on the first day. I'll never vote you out.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you right now, man to man, I'll never go back on that.
Yeah,
like I told you, you're the most popular guy in this tribe. And you'll be the most popular guy in the game. I ruffle people's feathers, you know, that's just me.
Yeah.
You say the same thing that I do and everybody laughs. I say what you say and everybody's like, whoa. And the truth shall set you free, Sierra.
Yeah.
Go and be free.
He's meditating.
He's having his morning meditation.
We're almost at day 20. Up till now, it's been about the team. So I've been trying to get along, but the little annoying things I've had to keep bottled in. I'm the kind of person that if I see it, I want to say it, I want to nail it, get rid of it. And I was like, you know what? I need to get centered. I need to pray. I need to meditate. And I spent about 10 minutes out in the water just getting refocused. And it was like, boom, and everything just clicked. You know, this is about me now. The feast, man, it's cool because we're meeting new people. You know, it's like getting a new girlfriend. There's all kinds of things to explore. I knew the first time that I looked at JT, I saw the cowboy boots, open, honest face, and I said to myself, he is a good old boy. We're kindred spirits. We both love the outdoors. I think that we're both warriors. I said in the very beginning of this game to everybody, I will not lie one time on this game. I have a lot of emotions going on. I have said that I felt Brendan was maybe a little bit squirrely. But if you flat out lied to me, you better be prepared to go to war. So what do you want to call me? You want to call me the orchestrator for orchestrating a beautiful move at this point in the game that does two things. Keeps my initial game plan intact, and I don't have to compromise by keeping weak people around, and voting out one of the strongest, most manipulative, and possibly most deceitful players to date. Or do you want to call me the Dragon Slayer because I'm cutting the head off of the dragon? You guys call me whatever you want to, because at this point in time, I feel brilliant. I just wanted to share a piece of my life with them. I wanted to show them that no matter how bad it gets in your life, there's always something that's going to make it much worse.
And I want you guys to know that there are three people in the world that know this story.
I want to hear this story.
So I shared with the tribe one of the stories about the time that I got caught in the Amazon and thought I was going to get killed.
I was airlifted in. I had a military helicopter drop me off a couple of feet from the ground up in the Peruvian border where the Amazon supposedly starts. And it was real rapid. I had an 18-foot kayak. I was paddling early one morning, and I just felt like I'm being watched. And I look over, and I think I see some indigenous people that are sitting there creeping through the bush. And at first, I counted six or seven of them. Now, they were probably, you know, four and a half feet tall, and they've got their bow and arrows drawn. They jerk me out of the kayak. They tie me up. They tie my hands behind my back. They tie my feet. They drag me into this hut. They tie me to this stake, and they take turns beating me with a club. I don't know how long it lasted. Sometimes I blacked out. Sometimes I just went to a faraway place. I knew they were about ready to kill me.
I thought I was going through that rope, and I slipped out the back.
I got in the kayak, and I dipped it in the water, and I paddled like hell. And I paddled so hard that my hands started bleeding,
I just can't describe the feeling of being stalked by another human being.
It's called Chongran, and it's an ancient Tibetan. If you do a Google search on it, you won't find it. It's only passed down verbally. I feel like I'm in control of this game. I have the Power Alliance commanding my officers, running the show like I was born to do. You know, if you look at it, to defeat an army, you have to cut off the head of the dragon, which is why I nicknamed Brendan the Dragon. Hence my name, the Dragon Slayer. Where does Sierra fit in all this? With the comments that she made today, Sierra is the bowel movements that comes out of the dragon after Brendan. Sierra's got to go.
None of us have ever done this in our lives.
I have.
Be the wizard, Steven. Be the wizard.
Coach, this really happened, or this is a movie version of what you want to have happen?
I try to actually tone it down, because if I tell them that that the tribe was, you know, looking at my ass, talking about eating my ass. So actually, you know, when I tell these stories, I usually try to give like the PG-13 version of it.
Coach, does it bother you that some people might question these stories?
I mean, what I've been through in my life, it's pretty fantastic. I got, you know, scars all over my body that I can point to of, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 of the life or death situations I've been through.
5, 6, 7, or 8 life or death situations?
Probably more than that. I mean, if you want me to recount them, I will. I've been through a hurricane, I've been attacked by a shark, had a run-in with a crocodile, got captured by the Indian tribe. I mean, there were some very defining moments in my life where I thought, these are the last 3 or 4 seconds. So does it bother me that people want to question that? They cannot question my integrity and my honesty. That's how I'm playing this game. That's how I play my life.
Coach, agree with that? If you're a physical threat in this game, it's time for you to go.
The 7 layers of heaven with the Vikings were determined on how they were defeated in battle. I want to surround myself with warriors.
So, Brent,
even if that means that they defeat me, I think that that's the honorable way to play this game.
The ancient samurai used to say that if you wanted to win the war, you had to cut off the head of the dragon. You, my friend, are the dragon, and I am the Dragon Slayer.
8th person voted out of Survivor Tocantins and the first member of our jury. Brandon, need to bring your torch. Brendan, tribe has spoken. We'll judge him by the amount of smiles. I'd say that was a pretty big blindside.